name is Kelly. I'm your online campus director, and it's a pleasure for me to be here with you today. Last week, I went to a Need to Breathe concert, and a lot of you guys probably recognize their music, whether you know it or not. But they have a new song out called I Am Yours, and I've had these two lines in my head over and over. Out of this whole album, these are the two that have stuck out to me. And this part that it's in says, "So why do I still try to prove that I deserve your time?" Talking about God. "Because I am yours, you will always be mine. It seems like madness, I'm invited to a table by your side." And I've just been thinking about that image about being at the right hand of Jesus, you know, at this banquet table. And I have never had the experience where you go into a lunchroom and you have a tray and you're like looking and you don't know where to sit. You know, that's kind of a thing people talk about. But I was thinking an experience I do have is that when I went to college in California, I worked at a coffee shop at a church that was like more than 5,000 people. Terry Crews went there, talked to him quite a bit. Michael Jr. Comedy, who has gotten a little more popular, he went there. B.B. Winans would lead worship all the time. Israel Houghton would lead worship all the time. Robert Downey Jr. had been there. So it was like, you know, a big thing. And I worked at the coffee shop, so I got to know a lot of these people and pastors and kind of the cool people from the church. And I remember being at Huntington Beach with all these people and looking around like, I do not belong here. Like, I am not one of these people. And even now looking back, one of them was on Jeopardy. One of them was with the LA Police Fire Department and was on some news because of this big rescue he did. I wrote down some stuff. The other one is a big worship leader down in Houston. Another one is an audio engineer at Disneyland. Anyway, so even now looking back, I'm like, I was way out of my league. And I felt totally out of place. And it just reminded me about that we belong at this table with Jesus, and he's there. And there's a story in Mark 2. It says he was having dinner at Levi's house. Many tax collectors and sinners were there. And then it talks later, it's called the parable of the great banquet in Luke 14. And it says that he now extends grace to those who have been shut out from the invitation. He's even going outside, inviting people who are not Jewish and inviting them to come to the table. And so I just think, whoever you are and whatever you've done and how awkward you feel and feel like you don't belong at church or in the kingdom of God, that's not true. And you can just look at the life of Jesus and see how he put that all to rest and says, you're invited. And it just seems like madness that we're invited to the table by his side, but it's true, he invites us. So let's just pray. God, I thank you that you have made us in a right relationship with you because of Jesus. We just praise you for that. And thank you so much that while we were outsiders, you did something crazy and you made it so that we can sit at your banquet table. And we just want to say thank you for that and help us keep that in mind when we come to you, that we can have that confidence. In your name, amen. All right, New Hope, we'll see you tomorrow.